Sheikh Abdullah was released and returned to Srinagar, where he was accorded a great welcome by the people of the valley. After his release, he was reconciled with Nehru. Nehru requested Sheikh Abdullah to act as a bridge between India and Pakistan and make President Ayub to agree to come to New Delhi for the talks for a final solution of the Kashmir problem. President Ayub Khan also sent telegram to Nehru and Sheikh Abdullah with the message that Pakistan too was a party to the Kashmir dispute and resolution of the conflict without his participation would not be acceptable to the Pakistan. Sheikh Abdullah went to Pakistan in the spring of 1964. President Ayub Khan of Pakistan held extensive talk with him to explore various avenues for solving the Kashmir problem and agreed to come to Delhi in mid-June for talks with the Nehrus as suggested by him. Even the date of his proposed visit was fixed and communicated to Delhi. However, while Abdullah was still in Pakistan, news came of the sudden death of Nehru on 27 May 1964. The peace initiative died with Nehru. After Nehru's death in 1964, Abdullah was interned from 1965 to 1968 and exiled from Kashmir in 1971 for 18 months. The plebiscite front was also banned. This was illegally done to prevent him and the plebiscite front, which was supported by him, from taking part in the election in Kashmir. On 21st November 1964, the Article 356 and 357 of the Indian Constitution were extended to the state, by virtue of which the central government can assume the government of the state and exercise its legislative powers. On 24th November 1964, the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly passed a constitutional amendment changing the elected post of Sardar Riyasat to a centrally nominated post of governor and renamed Prime Minister to the Chief Minister, which is regarded as the end of the road for the Article 370 and the constitutional autonomy granted by it. On 3 January 1965, prior to the 1967 Assembly election, the Jammu and Kashmir National Conference dissolved itself and merged into the Indian National Congress as a marked centralizing strategy. After Indo-Pakistani War of 1965, Kashmiri nationalist Amanullah Khan and Maqbool Bhatt, along with the Hashmi Qureshi, in 1966 formed another plebiscite front in Azad Kashmir with an armed wing called the National Liberation Front, NLF, with the objective of freeing Kashmir from Indian occupation and then liberating the whole of Jammu and Kashmir. Later in 1976, Maqbool Bhatt is arrested on his return to the valley. Amanullah Khan moved to England and their NLF was renamed Jammu and Kashmir Liberation Front, JKLF. Shortly after 1965 war, Kashmiri Pandit, activist and writer Prem Nath Fazaz wrote that the overwhelming majority of Kashmir Muslims were unfriendly to India and wanted to get rid of the political setup, but did not want to use violence for this purpose. He added, it would take another quarter century of repression and generation tenure for the pacifist approach to yield decisively as an armed struggle, qualifying Kashmiris as a reluctant secessionist. In 1966, the Indian opposition leader Jaya Prakash wrote to Indian Prime Minister Indira Gandhi that India ruled Kashmir by force. Revival of the National Conference 1975-1983. On 1971, the declaration of the Bangladesh independence was proclaimed on 26 March by Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, and subsequently the Bangladesh Liberation War broke out in East Pakistan between Pakistan and Bangladesh, which was later joined by India, and subsequently war broke out on the western border of India between India and Pakistan, both of which culminated in the creation of Bangladesh.